वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू। टुडेज टॉपिक इज़ फूड टॉक्सिकोलॉजी। लेट अस सी व्हाट इज टॉक्सिसिटी। सो द कैपेसिटी ऑफ एनी सब्सटेंस और एनी केमिकल कंपाउंड टू इंड्यूस और टू कॉज हार्मफुल इफेक्ट दैट इज इंजुरी विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू पैथोलॉजिकल बायोकेमिकल एंड हिस्टोपैथोलॉजिकल चेंजेस दैट इज टर्म्ड एज टॉक्सिसिटी। इट मीन द कैपेबिलिटी और कैपेसिटी ऑफ एनी केमिकल कंपाउंड टू कॉज the harmful effect is termed as toxicity. Let us see what is toxicants. So the substance that have been shown to present some significant degree of possible risk when consumed in sufficient quantity by humans or animals means the chemical compounds or substance that poses the risk of causing toxic effect are termed as toxicants. Toxicants can be classified as inherent toxicants and contaminants. So, inherent toxicants are those which are produced by plant itself as a secondary metabolite as their defense mechanism. For example, anti-nutritional factors present in fruits, vegetables and grains, protease inhibitors, lectins, phytates, etc. Next is contaminants. So, there are three types of contaminants: physical, chemical and microbiological. So this way toxicants can be classified. Next we will move on to the food toxicology and law. So Paracelsus once said that everything is poison. As we all know, any particular substance when consumed in excess quantity, it will definitely be harmful for our body. So ultimately Paracelsus said that everything is poison. Later on, according to the US FDA, in the provision of the Act, FD&C Act, there is a Delaney clause which look after about the ban of the food additives, or we can say the substance which are carcinogenic. So there are different sections under Delaney clause. They are section 409 for food additives, 406 for color additives and 1612 for animal feed and drugs. Let's move on to some terms in food toxicology. So let us see, before going in toxicology, what are the terms. So first term in food toxicology is acute toxicology. So it refers to a quick response, often immediate, which is induced by a single exposure. It means it causes a response which is very immediately. For example, hydrogen cyanide, which is very lethal chemical compound, we know that it induces death within minutes, even in quantity as 50 to 60 milligram. Again, ciclotoxin is a toxin present in water hemlock, which kills the cattle they feed upon. Okay, immediately. So acute toxicity of a substance is decided by LD50 value, that is lethal dose. Lethal dose 50 is defined as the substance that will kill 50% of the group of exposed animal or animal used for testing, that is lethal dose 50, LD50. So acute toxicity is the immediate response of the particular substance. Next term is chronic toxicity. So it refers to effect that requires some time to develop. For example, cancer. So testing for the chronic toxicity involves continuous feeding of the test animal, that is rodents, for 20 to 24 months, because as I have said that it takes time to develop the effect. So for determining the chronic toxicity, TD50 value is required, that is tumor dose 50. So tumor dose 50 can be defined as it is the dose required to induce cancer in 50% of group of exposed animal, that is tumor dose 50. So chronic toxicity means it requires some time to develop the toxicity. Next is subchronic feeding test. So it is a test of 90 days feeding test for the animal. Test animals, for example rodents. It is used to define the MTD, that is maximum tolerated dose for non-carcinogens and novel, that is no observable adverse effect level limit. So what is MTD? So maximum tolerated dose is the highest level of test substance that can be fed to an animal without inducing any toxic signs, okay, or any toxicity in the animal. So it is the maximum dose which we can give to an animal which should not show any toxic effect. So in chronic test, the test substance is typically fed at the MTD level to the test animals. Next is NOAEL, that is no observable adverse effect level. So for substance that induce a toxic response other than cancer, okay, in chronic feeding test, then the NOAEL is determined, and from the NOAEL, the ADI, that is acceptable daily intake, is determined, which the WHO or FAO, or we can say FSSAI, regulate or make the regulation for every food additives. So ADI is set as 1/100 of the NOAEL limit. Okay, so if any food additive after testing is determined as carcinogenic, then it is totally banned. If it is not carcinogenic but it poses some toxic effect, then its NOAEL is found, NOAEL limit is found, and from that NOAEL limit the ADI is set, and this is then circulated throughout the world for regulating different food additives. So this was about what is food toxicology, its classification, and what are the terms used in food toxicology. Thank you.